Hello, classmates and Professor Yeager. My name is Josh Fuller, and today I'm doing my geography in my backyard project on OP Schnabel Park, located here in San Antonio, Texas. To be more specific, it's between Helotes and Leon Valley, located here off Bandera Road. It's about 80 degrees out. It's kind of hot outside, but let's jump right into it. So this is the location of OP Schnabel Park. As you can see, it's located right here off Bandera Road. This is where I'm gonna be at right here. And I'm about to head into the park. So as you can see on this trail, it's obviously man-made, but much of the park is actually gonna be very natural. It's a natural area. So this right here is gonna be a good example of mass wasting. As you can see, that's the higher elevation up there, and it just goes down lower and lower elevation. This is a slope. So what it's do, as you can see, there's like some signs of rain here because it just rained, I believe, earlier this morning. So when it rains in a slope like this, it's going to bring down those rocks, and it's going to bring them down this way to move the way the slope is declining. And rocks are gonna start chipping away at other rocks, which makes them smaller. And as it rains, the rocks are just gonna keep chipping and chipping away, and it's just gonna get smaller and smaller and smaller. As you can see, it's also gated right here for safety, but after this little fence right here, it's just gonna go really a lot more steeper, and the elevation will decline by a great amount. So this right here is gonna be an example of biotic weathering. I'm gonna zoom in so y'all could see it better. So as you can see right here, there's gonna be grass right there and a few branches that are actually grown out of the rock, which makes it biotic weathering. And here at OP Schnabel Park, there's actually a lot of examples of biotic weathering. As you can see right here, there's a tree growing through, like over the rock, which is another example. And yeah, it's just a lot of biotic weathering going on right here. I also found another example of biotic weathering. As you can see, the branches right there, just give me one second, just growing out of the rock. Yeah, it's just, there's a lot of biotic weathering over here at OP Schnabel Park. And this is going to be what is known as a dry creek. It's kind of hard to go to see it because it's blocked off right here, just I guess for safety. But the dry creek down there is, it's only gonna have water like involved with it during the rainy season when it rains a lot. So that's a dry creek, which is a pretty good example. It's just really hard to see down there. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about physical weathering, also known as mechanical weathering. And this is a very good example right here. As you can see, there's like cracks between the rocks, which they're breaking down due to cold weather or frost, also known as frost wedging. And yeah, you can just see all these rocks that are just breaking down. Also, you can see right here, there's another good example of biotic weathering. There's some leaves growing out of there, and there's a root from a tree going through it right there. So it was kind of hard to find evidence and examples of chemical weathering, but I finally found one. As you can see right here, these little tiny holes in the rock, that's gonna be chemical weathering. And this is from carbonation, I believe, which is the mix of water and carbon dioxide, which makes these little holes right here in this rock. I mean, I don't want to say for sure, but it could also be due to rain, which eventually weathers it. But this is great evidence of chemical weathering. So that was my geography in my backyard project. And I just wanted to thank you all for watching. And thank you, Professor Yeager, for teaching a very interesting class throughout the semester. I really enjoyed it. and I think I can use some of that information in my further career. So thank you, Professor Yeager.